another. Welcome to another layout update by LNERFan4472. As you can see, the layout has progressed tremendously. Absolutely tremendously. I'm really, really proud of the result. Well, I'm proud of myself. As you can see, I now have Gauge Master 1/16th of an inch cork underlay laid from this track here to all these three tracks. And then we've got these three tracks going on, and I've also corked these. And it stops just here because I'm having a bit of trouble laying the flexi track just there. And yeah, I'm really, really happy with the result. You know, there's loads that I can do now. The only thing that worries me is how to lay it with flexi track. Comment below on how I do that, please. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Cork underlay wise, I'm really, really impressed with the result. Now, obviously Christmas has just passed, but I haven't received any new rolling stock or locomotives. In fact, I've received much better things that will aid in the growth of the layout. I bought these two sets of wires here, along with some tape, you know, some insulating tape, and this will be for the power bus that will go underneath the baseboard that will feed power to the parts of the layout that need it. For example, dead spots and accessory decoders, much like we have here. And I've also got a soldering iron, very, very handy. Just be extremely careful with these things, be really, really careful. And thanks to this soldering iron, I've been able to repair Eurostar, which has just been repaired. All she needs is a chip now, and it will come in handy, especially for times in the future when I'm installing point motors and, you know, working with chop blocks and things like that, and tinning wires. It's just one of those things that will last you a lifetime. You know, they are expensive to begin with, but they will last you. They will last you. Don't forget to buy some solder. And preferably some flux. I am fluxless at the moment. I really need some flux. It just helps the solder flow more easily, if you like. And it just makes things easy to work with overall. I am now going to try and install some point motors. I'm not going to go with surface mounted point motors. I've got up the charts as far as realisticness is concerned, and I'm going to go with undermounted point motors that go underneath the baseboard. Now, if you're an experienced modeller and have any recommendations on some point motors I can use that are compatible with the Hornby Digital Points and Accessory Decoder, please let me know in the comments section below. Now, I've been rather silly here, and it is a very, very silly move, because I want to install point motors that go underneath the baseboard, but I've drilled no holes. So basically what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to rip the points up and drill, because if I'm going to drill from the bottom out, the bottom upwards or upwards downwards, I'm obviously going to take the point with me, so that's going to have to come off. And this might be coming out, because I think I'm going to redesign this section here. Maybe to give this bit a bit more space for the turntable, because obviously there's going to be a track over here that leads out towards the turntable. I'm going to buy the Pico turntable, because, correct me if I'm wrong, the Helgen turntable is ridiculously overpriced. It's about £200. Yeah, 200 quid for a turntable. Now, obviously, if you're a very wealthy person, then obviously, yeah, go for it. Yeah, that's fine, you can pay it. I can't, on the other hand. I dare to say, currently unemployed. And in dire need of a job, so yeah, no Helgen point motor, thank you very much. I'm going to be going with the Pico one, and I'm going to try and motorise it myself. Now, you'll also notice that there's been a bit of progress over here. I've got the point in, that's probably going to be electrofrog in the future. I'm going to use plastic insulating fish plates, and, you know, if I start getting short circuits, I'm just going to insulate the whole thing. You know, put plastic fish plates there, there and there, and then connect this up to the power bus to give that power. You know, because all this becomes negative here when you connect it up. Basically, all insulating fish plates does is supplement this little plastic bit here. So it's just a further insulation over here. Plastic fish plates actually aren't that bad. They're not easily visible, and you really do have to get up close in order to see them. And I've got all the cork laid over here. This is all pinned down. And yeah. So what's going to happen here is the Metcalf kit is going to extend out to here. And there's going to be like a booking office sort of thing here. It's going to be the same story over here. These two tracks are going to face each other, and this is going to be preferably for diesel multiple units and suburban trains, because it's going to end here. I'm going to put some really fancy buffers just here, and then the platform will continue on much like it does over there, a bit like a mirror. It's mirrored, if you like, and I think it's just going to look fantastic. It's going to look a bit like York Station, but not on a curve. If you're familiar with York Station, you'll know what I'm talking about. And I just think it's going to be absolutely fantastic when it's finished. But hey, no layout is really ever finished. When I'm starting to make progress on this, which will be in the next 3 to 6 months, I think it'll just look absolutely fantastic, and I'm going to be really proud of it, and I hope you guys are as well. I've never really given the time to personally thank my subscribers for all the support they've been giving me. I have been on YouTube for about 1 year and 2 months now, and I have 220 subscribers, nearly 220 subscribers, and it's just been tremendous. I never expected this much support from the Model Rail community. And I promise to give you guys future content, improved content, and thank you very much for the support. Personally, thank you very, very much for the support. I never expected this level of support, and what can I say? Just keep liking, keep commenting, keep subscribing, and feedback would be much appreciated, please. Whether it be good or bad, I'm always willing to hear you out, no matter what. Well, guys. Guys and girls, thank you very much for the support over the last year and 2 months. As promised, I will be recording in 720p HD with autofocus from now on, courtesy of this new Samsung HMX-F80. What a beast. Yes, it doesn't record anything yet because I don't have a memory card for it yet. But I've done a few experiments with, if I open it up like this, and I've just been doing a few experiments with the focus and things like that, just looking at the screen and holding locomotives in front. And it's just a beast, It's not a quality, top-of-the-range camera, and it does take its time while focusing, but, it's something. It's better than this, what I've got now. Expect to see a new video from this, preferably a review. In fact, I might start doing re-reviews of locomotives. We haven't done a review of our beloved J52 yet, or our little Holden B12 over there. So I will get those videos out as soon as. Well guys, that's just about it for now, and I hope you've all had a very Merry Christmas, and once again, thank you very much for the overwhelming support. It's just been absolutely fantastic. I never expected this level of support. Once again guys, have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. If you want to see more of these videos, please like, comment, and of course subscribe. Thank you very much indeed.